I've always wondered about the question, can you hear me? Because those who can't answer. Well, we are neighbors from just down the road. And we're very proud of you. And I'm especially proud that I've been invited to speak here about Admiral Stockdale. Because for me, the powerful member of the family was Sybil Stockdale. The Admiral was a great man for whom I had tremendous admiration, but Sybil was something else. And let me tell you why I feel that strong. I became National Security Advisor in 1969. The war in Vietnam had gone on at that time for 8 years, more or less, certainly for four. And James Stockdale was captured, shot down in 65. By the time Nixon became president, and I did, was done the honor of becoming security advisor, the war had been going on for 4 years, the big time war and the lower, the military engagement for 8 years. The country was divided in a way that you cannot imagine today, with demonstrations, with most of the academic community joining demonstrators, and with constant implications that the government was missing opportunities to end the war. Nobody had a greater interest in ending the war than the president and myself. But there was one thing we wouldn't do. We would not turn over the people who had relied on us to communist rule. We insisted that the people of Vietnam have their choice of government. That was the only issue. I mention all of this because I met Sybil, because there was a league of families of prisoners who were in Vietnam. And I met with them every 2 months. About 100 women. And they'd come into the White House. And on the way to the White House, there were all these groups that were telling them to give us help. And on the way out of the White House, there were all these journalists. And they were all waiting for these ladies to say the administration was not doing enough. And if they just to make one more concession, but Sybil wouldn't have it. And she held these ladies together. And they were, people, or the two sons who are here, it's such a great joy for me. The two sons said, thank you for your support of Sybil. That's nonsense. She was supportive of me because it meant an enormous amount to Nixon and me. And this is a war we inherited that we hadn't started, to bring it to an honorable conclusion of which the men who were in prison could be proud. And so I was, on the one hand, it was anguishing to meet these wives. On the other hand, it was uplifting because of Sybil. And so that's how it started. And then I got to know the object of all these activities. And He was a man whose character was risen of the suffering. I became afterwards a particularly close friend of Senator McCain because when I was in Hanoi at the end of the war, I was given the opportunity to take him out with me on a presidential level by the Vietnamese. And I refused. I said, he has to get in line with all the others, and he will have to come out in turn. You have to remember, if I take out the son of the Pacific Fleet commander as a person. So I was wondering what would McCain say to me when I met him. And we met at the White House lawn, where Admiral Stockdale was also. And McCain walked up to me and said, thank you for saving my honor. And it wasn't just his honor. It was above all the honor of the Stockdales and the innumerable others who lived under these barbaric conditions and kept their faith in their country, and who had known that this was about freedom and about the importance of America. And then I saw the Admiral. He didn't become Admiral right away. At the War College, and we saw each other over the years, and he was always a symbol of the best in America, of what makes its country worth fighting for. A man who believed in freedom, who believed in his country, and who believed in the importance of our values around the world. And he did his job unostentatiously. And if you had congratulated him on doing his job, he wouldn't even have understood it, because he was doing his duty. It was the natural thing for him to do. So I want to thank Kensington, and all of you for giving me this opportunity to pay tribute to a couple in a time when we are always talking of our divisions and our uncertainties. They knew what they owed each other. They knew what they owed each other. And I cannot tell you how much it meant to me when I walked into that first meeting of the League and Sybil was standing there, keeping order. But in a motherly way, I mean, this was a, and is a great lady. And then her husband was worthy of it. So they are an example of what our country needs, what made our country great. And I cannot tell you how much it means to me to be permitted to say a few words about these two extraordinary